Now, the Lord Jesus is coming in judgment. And here it begins in verse 8, and here it is. I'll just have to read it to you. In flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power. Now, I want to say some things right at this particular spot. The Word of God actually says very little about heaven. And one of the reasons is it's so wonderful that we could not comprehend it. And the Lord does not want us to get so heavenly minded that we're no earthly good. Therefore, he wants us to keep our eyes down here on our walk, our pathway, and I'm not sure to keep our nose on the grindstone quite a bit of the time. Now, Scripture not only says very little about heaven, it says less about the condition of the lost. It's so awful that the Holy Spirit has drawn a veil over it, and there's nothing there to satisfy the morbid curiosity or the lust for revenge. Because you see, when God judges, God does not do it in a vindictive manner. He does it to vindicate, you see, his righteousness and his holiness. But there's nothing in the Scripture to satisfy the lust, but there's enough there that it ought to give you a warning. It does not mean that it's less real because so little is said. Actually, Christ said more about hell than anyone else. Hell's an awful reality, and I'm not going to speculate on it. I'm just going to give what is said right here. It's bad enough. He's coming in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power, when he shall come to be glorified in his saints and to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day. Now, hell's ridiculed today, and that doesn't mean it doesn't exist. It was also, not too many years ago, it was a popular notion that Hitler would not plunge Europe into a war and make a holocaust of the whole thing and turn Europe into a flaming fire. But he did. Oh, the dreamers. The man that took the umbrella and went over to meet with Hitler and Mussolini. And he came back and said, we'll have peace in our time. Well, we didn't and we don't today. There were many that thought that Japan would not attack America. Now, it's not popular for me to say this right now, but our government at that time didn't believe they would, and the liberal churches at that time were teaching pacifism, if you please. Now, whether they believed it or not, there was a Pearl Harbor. My friend, there is a hell, and Christ is coming to this earth someday. First, he's going to take his own out of the earth, as we'll see next time. But he's coming, and it will be a terror to the wicked. It will be a judgment. Those that know not God, it's life eternal to know him, and who obey not the gospel. That is the thing here. This is the work of God. You want to work for your salvation? This is the work of God, that you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. That's what the Word of God says. Now, you can make it look very nice today. And I would like to say this. I hear a great many testimonies today. I have a book that someone sent me, and I returned it because of the fact it was filled with I. Nothing very much about the Lord Jesus other than this man. He got rich, he had a good personality, he'd saved his home, everything. Oh, it was just wonderful. And it was. But there's nothing in his testimony, and there's nothing in the average testimony I hear today of a person who says, I was a hell-doomed sinner going straight to hell. I was lost, and he saved me. My friend, that's the important thing to say in your testimony, not what he's done for you today in the gimme-gimme side. What did he deliver you from? That's the reason that he came. He came to redeem us, friends, not to give you a new personality and make you a successful businessman. He came to deliver you from hell, my friend. Now, that's not popular today. People don't like that. But a lot of folk don't like to be told they had cancer. Dear lady would not go to the doctor. She knew she had cancer because the first time she went, he said she did. She would not go back. She insisted it was something else. No use me telling you, they buried her. She's been buried now for a long time. She had cancer, and the doctor told her the truth, but she was not prepared to see it. And today, there's too few that are telling folk this, that you are lost. Now, may I say to you, if somebody came, you were out yonder in a burning building, and a man came in there when you were asleep. He waked you up, and he shocked you, and he picked you up, and he carried you out of that burning building. And he liked you, and he's a rich man. He made you his son, brought you into his home, a lovely home, and then made over to you so many wonderful things. Now, what would you, if you got up before a group of people to thank him, what would you thank him for? Would you thank him for the fact he'd made you his son? I hope you would. That'd be good. But what would you really thank him for? Wouldn't you really thank him because he rescued you out of that burning building? Now, here, the judgment of the wicked is coming. Now, if you want to stay in that class, you're going to be judged. Somebody ought to tell you that. And I'm going to tell you that. Now, will you notice what he says here? Verse 11, wherefore also we pray always for you that our God would count you worthy of this calling and fulfill all the good pleasure of his goodness and the work of faith with power. Now, he does want to do good things for you today, but he saved you from something. That's important, that the name of our Lord Jesus Christ may be glorified in you and ye in him according to the grace of our God and the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, if God has prospered you, made you a successful businessman, and you can get up and glorify Christ, fine. But what about these poor saints? I have a letter of a woman that's right here in Los Angeles in a hospital and been there flat of her back for most of her life, and has a radiant testimony. I'll be honest with you, my friend. It's nice to get up before a comfortable group after you've had a banquet in this affluent society and brag about how God has blessed you. What about that woman lying on that bed? She has a radiant testimony. I say to you, she's glorifying God. I'm not quite sure about you, brother. I'm not quite sure about you and about me today whether we glorify him when we boast of the fact that he's so blessed us today, and he has. But he's also delivered us from hell. That doesn't sound good today, does it? But that happens to be what the Word of God says, and it's